Hi, I'm Ryan Hughes with the Pix4D Training Team. In this video, we will discuss the differences between single grid and double grid aerial imagery. To demonstrate the difference between a single grid and a double grid mission when capturing images with a drone, I will concentrate on mapping a single building and its surrounding property. The techniques and limitations of both mission types that you will see can be applied on a larger scale. The most straightforward mission is a single grid. Generally speaking, a single grid mission generates a high-quality 2D representation of an area of interest, since the camera often points directly at the ground. However, if you require 3D reconstructions, you might be disappointed with the results from a single grid mission. Since the camera is at the nadir perspective, it does not capture the vertical faces of objects, especially under overhanging roofs or other objects. When flying a single grid mission, we recommend capturing at least 75% front and 60% side overlap. Front overlap is the overlap between consecutive images, and side overlap is between adjacent flight lines. 75% front and 60% side image overlap are the minimum overlap values we recommend when conditions are ideal for photogrammetry. However, you may find that you must capture more overlap to achieve the results you need to get the job done. If your scene has homogeneous, reflective, or dynamic areas, it is recommended to increase the overlap. The ideal overlap depends on the project's goals, the camera's resolution, and many other external factors. For Pix4D software, we recommend only the minimum values of 75% frontal overlap and 60% side overlap, since we have seen that these values generate consistently good results. If you fly with less overlap than this, you risk having gaps between your images, resulting in areas not being adequately reconstructed. This can be due to many factors, but one of the principal factors is that the drone has deviated from the perfect route while capturing the images. Whenever you fly any grid mission, the best practice is to fly one flight line beyond the extent of the project area. By capturing at least one flight line's worth of images beyond the area of interest, you reduce the risk of not having enough image content at the edges. The double grid mission is similar to a single grid mission, except you fly two sets of flight lines that are perpendicular to each other, and the camera is oriented at a slightly oblique angle. Due to the oblique angle, a double grid mission typically requires at least 85% frontal and 70% side overlap. The camera should be oriented at a slightly oblique angle relative to the ground to ensure you generate a more comprehensive 3D representation of your area of interest. By setting the camera at a more oblique angle, the camera will capture more image content of vertical surfaces that would otherwise be hidden from view if the camera was pointing straight down. The camera's angle will depend on the area of interest, what you need to capture, and the camera options available for your drone. A 70-degree angle provides a good angle to capture vertical faces without capturing too much detail of objects in the background or the sky. When choosing the angle for your camera, be sure that the object or area of interest fills as much of each image as possible. Any pixels that capture the sky or objects not in the area of interest are wasted and can create noise in the reconstructions that needs to be removed during processing. Just like with a single grid mission, remember to fly one flight line beyond the extent of the project area. If you cannot capture a project area with a single battery or require additional detail of specific regions, you can fly multiple double grid missions to capture it. Now that we have discussed the basics of both grid missions, let's go into the field and capture the images. For this tutorial video, I will fly both a single grid and a double grid of the same project area with the same parameters. I will use Pix4D Capture Pro with the DJI Mini 3 Pro to capture the images. For this video, I flew the drone with the 12 megapixel camera at 35 meters or a little less than 120 feet. I used a front overlap of 80% and a side overlap of 70% for both missions. The single grid mission with the camera at the nadir perspective took 3 minutes and 30 seconds to capture 72 images. The double grid mission with the camera at an oblique angle of 70 degrees took 7 minutes and 20 seconds to capture 167 images. Due to the oblique angle and the double grid, the mission time was slightly more than double than was required for the single grid. When deciding between a single or double grid mission, it is important to know what deliverables you need at the end of the project. If you only require 2D reconstructions, such as the orthomosaic and digital surface model, then a single grid with the camera at a nadir perspective is sufficient. If you require 3D reconstructions, or don't know if you will, fly a double grid and capture the project area with an oblique perspective. That way, you can generate high-quality 2D and 3D reconstructions. In this video, I will process the nadir and oblique images separately with Pix4D-Matic to demonstrate the difference between the two grid missions. For the nadir imagery, I will work with the nadir processing template. For the oblique images, I will use the oblique processing template. The other processing options will be the same for all our 2D and 3D representations of reality. Now that both projects are finished, let's examine the results. The best way to compare the two is to examine the dense point cloud or mesh, which are 3D reconstructions. On the left of the screen is the single grid mission, and on the right is the double grid mission. Here you can see the difference between the dense point clouds. Since the single grid images were captured with the camera facing directly at the ground, the camera did not capture much of the building's vertical surfaces. In contrast, the double grid has captured most of the vertical faces. This is the main difference between the two types of image capture. If we look at the DSM and the orthomosaic, the two will be similar, though there might be slight differences due to the different camera angles and the slightly different GSD of the images. The main difference between a single grid and a double grid is the project's final result, especially in 3D, as can be seen here in the mesh. A single grid has the camera at a nadir angle, meaning it looks straight at the ground. This mission type is designed to capture images primarily for 2D reconstructions. This does not mean you cannot work with nadir images in 3D, but you might be missing the vertical faces of any structures or objects. If you require vertical faces, a double grid with the camera at an oblique perspective will provide better results. Choosing which grid mission to fly depends on the project's final deliverables. If you only require a digital surface model or an orthomosaic, a single grid mission will save time capturing the images and processing them. If you need better 3D reconstructions, fly a double grid with the camera at an oblique angle around 70 degrees. If you don't know, I recommend flying a double grid, that way you or your client can decide later. I hope this video showing the differences between single and double grid missions was helpful. When capturing images for photogrammetry, always determine your desired deliverables, GSD, and project goals before capturing the images. Happy mapping!